anywhere you have a reservoir of water, you can utilize this technology. Actually, our idea is that once we have finished the study, then we should be able to take this to our hydropower facilities in West Nile, in Nyagak. Because you know the Nyagak River, unlike the River Nile, it dries up during the dry season. And that's where we would have the maximum potential for solar energy. So, you know, we are going to have like a hybrid of solar and hydropower. So in the rainy season like now, you use a lot of hydropower. When the dry season comes, then you switch onto solar energy. So that is the strategy.
In June 2019, Sweden signed, or the Swedish embassy signed, an MOU with the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development in order for us to jointly pursue the development of Uganda's energy sector with an emphasis on renewable energy. And through the MOU, the idea was to identify joint priority projects executed by Swedish companies using Swedish financing while ensuring capacity building of the Ugandan staff within the energy sector. And I'm very happy to see that this capacity building is already ongoing on a rather large scale, actually, through one of the different actors in the Team Sweden. And it was after the signing of this MOU that the UGCL and Swedfund began discussing their collaborations on various projects